Back home, police are out in force in Narre Warren tonight as they race to track down a man wanted over a savage sword attack. Paul Dowsley joins us now, and Paul, he's considered very violent and very dangerous.
And getting him off the streets, Mitch, is their highest priority tonight, given the horrifying random nature of this attack on a couple on Sunday. Police say they both easily could have been killed. So police are swarming the area tonight and across the next few days until they find this man. And yesterday they came very close to doing just that.
A smiling swordsman, just 10 minutes after he slashed a random couple in Narre Warren North.
They felt that like they were going to die.
These are the horrifying wounds he left his victims with. The 70-year-old man and his 57-year-old partner were walking at the Troops Creek retarding basin Sunday morning when they noticed the man with what they thought was a fishing rod across his back acting oddly.
Stalking type behaviour.
The woman said good morning. He replied the same.
And within seconds, he started screaming and was approaching them with the sword sort of held up above his head.
He went for the woman first.
Lunged at her with a with the sword towards her chest area. The male victim has shown a lot of bravery and has stepped in and he sort of grabbed onto the blade.
He suffered severed tendons and ligaments and broken bones. Both victims required surgery.
Quite a frenzied attack.
The woman fell to the ground, her partner protecting her. Then a chilling moment.
The offender steps back and just stares at them for about 10 seconds and then walks off.
CCTV cameras have been installed, street patrol stepped up, the critical incident response team and the dog squad called in.
Two of those officers spotted the attacker with the sword yesterday morning as he walked into the park. They waited for backup, given the high risk. But despite a swift response and a 2.5 hour search, including from the air, they couldn't find him.
This investigation and the resolution of it is our highest priority.
Paul Dowsley, 7 News.